So let's start the second question. That means here in this lecture, I am going to explain another two different questions for you people. The questions are like that. If omega is a cube root of unity and a matrix H is an odd matrix of order 2 by 2, where it's a diagonal matrix, omega 0, 0, omega, then what is the value of H to the power 100? That means if we multiply the matrix H for 70 times, then what will be the correct option? And another question is also there, if A is a matrix of order 3 by 4 and B is a matrix such that A transpose B and B A transpose are both defined, then B is of which one is correct? What is the order of the matrix B? We have to find it out. So let's start the first one. Here what is given? A is equal to is a matrix where omega 0, 0 omega. That means this matrix can also be written exactly omega, correct? It will be omega 1, 0, 0, 1. That means we can easily take omega common from this, it's an every element of the matrix. So next, we have to find out H to the power 70, this is equal to omega to the power 70 and 1, 0, 0, 1. That means whatever may be the power of the identity matrix, that means whatever may be the time we multiply the identity matrix, it will be an identity matrix once again. So that's why H to the power 70 is equal to omega to the power 70 1. That means as it is written that omega is a cube root of unity, that's why omega cube is always equal to 1. And it will be omega to the power 69 omega 1 0 0 1. Am I correct? So omega to the power 69 means omega cube 23 into omega 1 0 0 1. So omega cube is equal to 1, 1 to the power 23 is also equal to 1. That's why the remaining expression will be omega 0 0 omega, which is equal to the H itself. That means H to the power 70 is equal to H. Which option is correct? Option C is correct. Okay? So that means in this way we have to generalize, we have to find out the answer of any question which is related to the transpose of any matrix. I have selected all those questions from the transpose portion, transpose matrix. So let's start the second one. In the second one, what is given? What is the matrix of the order of matrix A? A is a matrix of order 3 by 4. We have to find the matrix of B. Then what is the matrix, order of the matrix A transpose? Obviously it will be 4 by 3. Is it clear? Then order of the matrix A transpose will be 3 by 4 by 3. What is given? It is given that A transpose into B is defined. That means we can easily find out the product of A transpose and B. What is the order of the matrix A transpose? 4 by 3. Okay? Then obviously, what will be the order of the matrix B? As the multiplication of A transpose and B defined, it is known to us whenever the order of the number of column of the first matrix is equal to the number of row of the second matrix, then multiplication exists. That means without having any doubt or using the properties of multiplication, we can say that the number of row of the matrix B is equal to 3. But we don't have any idea about the number of columns. We don't have any idea. Suppose this one is A transpose B is defined. It is also given that B A transpose is also defined. We have got that for B, number of row is 3. B A transpose means here B will be there, here A transpose will be there. What is the order of the matrix? A transpose is equal to 4 by 3. As multiplication exists, number of column of the first matrix should be equal with the number of row of the second matrix. That means this one must be equal to 4. Here the same matrix you have got. That means for the matrix B, what is the number of row? 3. For the matrix B, what is the number of column? 4. That's why the order of the matrix B is 3 by 4. 3 by 4, option B is correct. In this way, because it is given that A transpose B and B A transpose defined. That means their multiplication exists. Multiplication exists means number of column of the first matrix should be equal to the number of row of the second matrix. That's why as the number of column of the matrix, number of row of the matrix A transpose is known to us, which is equal to 4. That's why number of column of the matrix B should be equal to 4. But here in this condition, we have thought that as the number of column of the first matrix is equal to number of row of the second matrix. As the order of the matrix A transpose is known to us, what is the column number of column 3? That's the number of rows will be equal to 3. Here from this one expression, from this one condition, we have got a number of row 3. From here this one expression, we have got number of column 4. That's why the order is 3 by 4. So option B is correct. I hope you are getting my point. Thank you so much. Here in this lecture, I have selected one question for you people from JE Advanced from 2015. Chapter is matrices. So that means in general, it is actually just we think that in advanced level, so that the difficulty level of the question is comparatively more. But some questions are there from matrices and determinant chapter, where you can easily find out the answer using simple concepts of matrices. So using such type of simple ideas, I am going to explain one question for you people. Just have a look. The question is this one. X and Y are two skew symmetric matrix of order 3 by 3 and Z is a symmetric matrix of order 3 by 3. Three matrices either X, Y and Z. Out of X, Y and Z, X and Y are skew symmetric and Z is symmetric matrix. Then which of the following matrix or matrices are skew symmetric? Four options are given. Out of the four options, which one is symmetric? Which one is skew symmetric? You have to find out. Maybe one option is correct, or maybe more than one option is also correct. Maybe correct. So then, what is the main condition to be? Under what condition we can easily say that, or using what condition we can easily say that a matrix is symmetric or skew symmetric? That means to have the idea about the symmetric or skew symmetric nature of a matrix, we have to find out its transpose. If A transpose is equal to A, then the matrix will be considered as symmetric. And if A transpose is equal to minus A, then it will be known as skew symmetric. Then obviously, product of two matrix is a matrix. Here also, product of these two matrix is a matrix. And difference between two matrix is again a matrix. That means we will consider this one as a single matrix. Here also we will consider this one as a single matrix. We will consider this one as a single matrix and this one expression will be considered as a single matrix. Considering this one matrix as A, we need to find out its transpose. After finding its transpose, if you get the same expression, then it will be symmetric. If you are getting an expression which is differed by the sign, that means minus sign is there, then it will be skew symmetric. Using that property, we will try to find it out. That means this expression will be considered as A here. We can easily consider this one as A here. This one expression will be considered as A and this one expression will be considered as A. So let's start. First of all, what are the properties here? A to the power n whole transpose should be equal with A transpose 4 to the power n, meaning this remains same. A to the power n whole transpose is exactly equal to A transpose to the power n, meaning it will remain same. That is, using the three properties, we are going to find out the answer of this one option will be the correct one. Okay? So, first option, let's suppose A is what is given? X, Y are skew symmetric. That means X transpose is equal to minus X, Y transpose is equal to minus Y because they are skew symmetric, and Z transpose is equal to Z. We will try to apply all those properties. Okay? And now, let A is equal to suppose Y cube Z to the power 4 minus Z to the power 4 Y cube. Then what is the value of A transpose? A transpose means Y cube Z to the power 4 minus Z to the power 4 Y cube whole transpose. Then A minus B whole transpose is equal to Y cube Z to the power 4 whole transpose minus Z to the power 4 Y cube whole transpose. Again, it is known to you, AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. That's why it will be Y cube whole transpose, it will be Z to the power 4 whole transpose Y cube whole transpose minus, here it will be Y cube whole transpose Z to the power 4 whole transpose. Applying this property, we have got the answer. Again, it is known to you, A to the power n whole transpose is equal to A transpose whole to the power n. Correct? Meaning it will remain same. That's why you can easily write down Z z transpose whole to the power 4, y transpose whole cube, y transpose whole cube, z transpose whole to the power 4. What is the meaning of z transpose? Z transpose is equal to z. That means we have got z to the power of 4. What is the value of y transpose? Y transpose is equal to minus y, and minus y whole cube means minus y cube. Minus y transpose whole cube. What is the value of y transpose? Minus y. That means in place of y transpose, we will write a minus y, and minus y whole cube means plus y cube. And z transpose means z equals to this one. That means this expression can be written as y cube z to the power of 4 minus z to the power of 4 y cube. That means we have got A. Am I correct? We have got the same matrix. Y cube z to the power of 4 minus z to the power of 4 y cube. That means we have come to know it. This one is symmetric. First one is symmetric. We have got it. But we have to find out this one. We have to find out a skew-symmetric matrix. So let's, in the same way, using all those properties, let us try to find out the other options also. Apply the same property here. Let us consider again, A is equal to x to the power of 44 plus y to the power of 44. Then what is the value of A transpose, which is equal to x to the power of 44 plus y to the power of 44 whole transpose? We know that it will be x to the power of 44 whole transpose plus y to the power 44 whole transpose. So x transpose is known to us already. We have explained it about y transpose whole to the power 44. X transpose is equal to minus x. That means minus x whole to the power 44 plus minus y whole to the power 44. It will become x to the power 44 plus y to the power 44, which is equal to a again. That means this one is symmetric. We have got the same expression. A transpose is equal to A, and this is nothing but the symmetric property. Okay. In the same way, let us try to find out, we have to find out these two symmetric properties, these two symmetric terms. So let us try to find out the next one. X to the power 4 z cube minus z cube x to the power 4. What is the value of A transpose then? Z x to the power 4 z cube minus z cube x to the power 4 transpose. Then it will become x to the power 4 z cube whole transpose z cube x to the power 4 whole transpose. Again, applying that property, z cube whole transpose x to the power 4 whole transpose x to the power 4 whole transpose z cube whole transpose, and it will become z transpose whole cube x transpose whole to the power 4 x transpose whole to the power 4 z transpose whole cube. So z transpose equal to z, it will be z cube. X transpose equal to minus x, it will be x to the power 4. X transpose equal to minus x. Minus x to the power 4 means x to the power 4. It will be x to the power 4, it will be z cube. What you have got here? What is the first term? X to the power 4 z cube. But we have got here z cube x to the power 4. But remember, in matrix, they may be commutative or may not be commutative. But what we have got here, x to the power 4, z cube, we have got here, what we have got is z cube x to the power 4. That means here the first term lies in the second position, and the second term lies in the first position. That means they are defined by the sign. That means if we take minus common, so it will be have x to the power 4 z cube minus z cube x to the power 4. Which is equal to what? Minus a. That means we have got an a transpose equal to minus a. That's why the matrix is skew symmetry. This option is correct. But we don't even know the next option. Let us try to find it out. What will happen? So let us try to find out the next option. So the next option, what is the very simple? X to the power 23 plus y to the power 23. A transpose is equal to x to the power 23 plus y to the power 23 whole transpose. So it will be x to the power 23 whole transpose plus y to the power 23 whole transpose. So it will be x transpose whole to the power 23 plus y transpose whole to the power 23. Is it clear? So x transpose equal to minus x, so minus x to the power 23 minus y to the power 23. Y transpose equal to minus y, so it will be, as the power is odd, so minus will be remain same. That means you can say minus of x to the power 23 plus y to the power 23, which is equal to minus a. A transpose equal to what? Minus a, you have got it. That's why this one is Q symmetric equation. That means which one option is correct? Correct option is C and D both. Both the option is correct here. I hope you are getting my point. What is the main property or main key point? That means whenever you have to take the symmetric as well as the asymmetric property of any matrix, always try to find it out. It's transpose. If A transpose equal to A, symmetric. If A transpose equal to minus A, it will be symmetric. Whatever will be the question, if the question is totally relatively symmetric and supersymmetric, apply the transpose property. Thank you so much for watching the video. Thank you.